In this video, we're going to look at the new Passwords app that Apple introduced with the iPhone and iOS 18. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at the Passwords app that was introduced with iOS 18 on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, in the past, if you wanted to look up a password for a website, what you needed to do was go into the Settings app, and then there was a setting for passwords. Now, this only allowed you to look up passwords for websites. If you wanted to look up a Wi-Fi network password, what did you have to do? You had to go into the Settings app, and then you had to go over to Wi-Fi. Well, maybe what you want to use is an authenticator, like Google Authenticator. Well, you couldn't do that with Apple. You had to use a third-party app. Well, now with iOS 18, as well as iPadOS 18 and macOS Sequoia, Apple separated their passwords out into its own separate app. And not only can you look up your passwords for various websites, but you can also use it as an authenticator, much like Google Authenticator, and you can manage your passkeys as well as look up your Wi-Fi networks. Let's take a look at this Passwords app. I'm going to tap on it to open it up. It does require Face ID, so it's going to look at my face here, and then it's going to unlock it. So now I'm looking at this Passwords app. And we can see it's pretty simple to use. Basically, what we have here are six different categories. I could almost say seven when we use shared passwords. So basically, I can look up all of my different passwords here. I just tap on All, and I can see all of my passwords. Up here, we have our search, so I can search for one. And if I wanted to open one up, let's go ahead and open this one up here. What I'm able to do is look up the username. I can see the password here. Now you're going to see it is blanked out here because I'm sharing my screen. So this is a nice little effect or a nice little feature that Apple implemented when I'm sharing my screen. But I can actually see that password if I were to tap on it. You cannot. So it's just a blank screen here for you. But if you were to look at it on your phone, you would actually see a number of dots here. You tap on it and then you're able to copy it or even view it. In addition to that, we can see what the website is that it's going to be used for. And if I want to share it, we can create different groups so I can share my passwords with other people. I can just go and select which group I want to use. And then we can see what the security is. This is using a custom password, so this is pretty good. So that's basically all we have to do. If we want to edit it, we can go up here to edit, and then I can go and edit this. So from here, I'm able to change the password. I can set up a verification code. I can even add notes, and these notes are searchable. So again, pretty simple to use. I'm going to tap on Done up here. Now, in addition to that, what we're also able to do, I'm going to go back over to my passwords here so I can see them all. Now, in addition to that, we can also see our passkeys. This is a replacement for passwords. Basically, instead of storing a password, what it's going to do is it's going to store a passkey on your device. I do have one passkey here, and it's for Best Buy, so I can actually view that passkey here. And again, if I were to go to Best Buy, instead of me entering my password, what it would do is it will automatically enter in this passkey, which is stored on my device. And these passkeys are shared among all of your different devices. So I can go to my iPad or even my Mac and it will also use that passkey. So you don't necessarily have to remember a password. This is relatively new, so you're starting to see it on more and more websites, but I think it's going to take a couple more years before it's really fully implemented. It's still a little bit clunky in my opinion, but it is going to be where things are moving towards, and the Passwords app does support this. Also, what I'm able to do is view codes. Now, this is something equivalent to Google Authenticator. When I tap on this, what I'm able to do is view a six-digit code when you're using Authenticator, for those of you who are familiar with Google Authenticator. Basically, when you go to a website, it asks for a code, and you have to go into this little area here and look up that code. The code changes every, I believe, 60 seconds. But basically, you're able to go and use this as your authenticator. So you no longer have to use Google Authenticator. If you want to look up your Wi-Fi passwords, you can do that as well. So I tap on this. and then I can see my Wi-Fi passwords just by tapping on any one of these. So if I wanted to see my home network here, I could tap on that and it'll show me that password. And then we have security here. You can see I have 658. These are older passwords here. But basically what this is going to do is just give me an audit of my passwords here, and we can see that most of them here are compromised passwords. So now what I would want to do is tap on this and go and change that password. Now, if you have a lot of them, like what I do here, what I would recommend doing is prioritizing the sites. Go into your banking sites and your shopping sites, your important, your critical sites, and go and change those passwords first. The whole idea here is when something is compromised here, if someone knows that password, that means that they're going to be able to get into another website because you're using the same password. So you want to go and change that password. And you can do that just by tapping on any one of these. So this is where you can get a nice little audit of your passwords. And then we also have deleted passwords. So when you go and delete a password, what you're able to do is go and recover it. We also have shared groups. Down here, you're going to see that I have these groups here, and I can create a new group. The whole idea with this is if you want to share a password with someone else, maybe I want to share my banking password with my wife. What I can do is I can go and create a new group here and then invite Beth over to it, and I can share that password with her. So then it's going to show up in her passwords app. So in addition to showing or having just your passwords, you're also able to create multiple shared groups and share them with other people. If you want to create your own password, it should remember when you go to a website, it should remember this in the app automatically, but you can create your own. All you have to do is just tap on the plus down here, and when you do, you're able to label it. You can enter in a username, you can go and enter in a password, and if you want to share it, you can do that, and of course, you can go and add notes. Again, it's pretty basic, but it is nicely laid out, and all you have to do is just go and search for the password that you want, or you can go to the category here and look for the password within a specific category. And if you want to go and add your own username and password, you just tap on the plus here. Let's take a quick look at the settings. There are a couple of settings in this, so I'm going to swipe up here. And now what we need to do is we need to go over to our settings app. From here, what we do is we swipe all the way down to the bottom here, and you're going to see apps. This is where Apple moved all of the settings for specific apps or third-party apps and even Apple apps. So I'm going to tap on apps here, and then I'm going to go to the P down here where we can see our passwords or our app for passwords, our settings for passwords, and you're going to see it right down here. So now I just tap on passwords, and there are the settings for it. Our first option here is show accounts as, and it's set for titles. So when I go back over to my passwords app, you're going to see that when I look at my list of passwords here, they are listed by title. Well, if you'd rather have them listed by website, you can do that. So we just go back over to our settings here. I'm in my password settings, and what we're able to do is change it to listed as a website. So instead of the title, it'll show the website. In addition to that, what we're able to do is turn on and off the compromised password. So if you don't want to have that audit in there, you can just go and turn that off. I can also have it suggest strong passwords. I would highly recommend that you leave this on. It's going to suggest a strong password and remember it in the passwords app so you don't have to remember it. And then you can also have it allow automatic passkey upgrades. Again, I would recommend leaving this on as well. So then when the passkey is updated, it'll also update it on your passwords app or in your passwords app. If you want to view the autofill settings, you can go down here and change your autofill settings. So I have it set to autofill my passwords and passkeys, and I would recommend doing this as well. So now when I go and create a new account on a website or in an app, what it'll do is it'll save it in that passwords app, and then I'm able to access it from my iPad or my iPhone. In addition to that, we are also able to use other browsers. You're going to see that down here it says autofill from. Where do I want it to autofill from? Well, I want it to autofill from my passwords app here, of course, so it's going to use my passwords to autofill. And what I can also do is set it to use Chrome to autofill. So let's go ahead and turn that on. And now What it'll do is it'll save any passwords in Chrome. And when we get those verification codes, those two-factor authentication verification codes, what we can do is we can have them delete after their use. So once I use them, what it'll do is it'll automatically delete them. So I'm going to turn this on. I would recommend turning that on as well. And for that Google Authenticator, I should say for authentication such as Google Authenticator, what you can do is you can have it set up in an app that you want. In my case here, because I'm using the Passwords app, I'm going to keep it as Passwords. So those are the settings, and they're basically in two different spots. A little confusing, but not too bad. We have our autofill and passwords. This is our settings for autofill. And then we also have our settings for our Passwords app. And that is located down at the bottom under apps, and we would go and look up Passwords there. And then we have settings for the Passwords app itself. So there's settings for autofill, and then there's settings for passwords. So that is the new Passwords app on the iPhone with iOS 18. In addition to being on the iPhone, if you have iPadOS 18 or macOS Sequoia, you also see that app on there. It is no longer located in the Settings app. It's a pretty simple app, very easy to use. Basically, it'll just save your passwords in there. You can look up passwords, and it'll group them by category. So you can see your pass keys or your Wi-Fi passwords or your authentication, your login authentication, such as what you would use with Google Authenticator. And then you can also create shared groups and share your passwords with other people. So that is the new Passwords app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, you can subscribe to my channel, or even share it with friends or family. In addition to that, I would recommend checking out danstutorials.com. Even though I have over 400 videos on YouTube, on my site I have over 2,000 videos. I've been doing this a lot longer on my site than I have with YouTube. So how can you help support my efforts in creating these videos? Well, my site is a membership-based site. You can view the videos, but they do come with ads. When you become a member of my site, I take out all of the ads. You also have access to an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and you have access to my classes and webinars, which I hold on a regular basis. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office. I'm not part of some big organization. I record these in a second bedroom in my office or in my home that I turned into a studio. So in addition to all of those other benefits, you are helping support a small business. Check out Dan's tutorials for more information, and thanks for watching.